A few days ago, I published a video on management tool for Kubernetes. In that video, I mentioned Prometheus and Grafana as the most popular open source solutions for monitoring Kubernetes. And that got me thinking it would be fun to do a video on how to install that. And it seemed easy enough. And it is. It is easy to install with Helm charts. It's just a couple of commands. But the tricky part always is what comes after that. You know, things like setting up data persistence, security, and access control. This is exactly what this video is about. We're going to install Prometheus and Grafana and set it up for data persistency. I'm thinking about making a second part to cover what I couldn't fit on this video, like network policies, ingress controllers, and persistence in the cloud. If that sounds interesting to you, leave me a comment or a message or like, so I know I should focus on that next. Now, let's dive in. The way this is going to work is I will create fixed mount points in my master node. They will be mapped to my home folder in my machine. We'll use those folders to store and persist data for Prometheus and Grafana. I'm going to use K3S. This is a lightweight Kubernetes distribution. You can run it on any machine, your machine, on the edge, on CI/CD, IoT. You can even run it on Raspberry Pi. It works on ARM chips, so you can run it pretty much anywhere. To follow the tutorial, you'll need a few tools installed. I covered most of them in a previous video. I'm going to create a new cluster using the K3D tool. If you already have a cluster ready, you can skip to this timestamp. The first thing we're going to do is create directories in my home for Prometheus and Grafana. Now I create the Kubernetes cluster with K3D. I map my home directory to the master server root here. This is going to be my mounted volumes for persistence. This maps the server directory to my home directory. And I create one server with two agents. I will create a namespace called monitoring. And then I use Kubernetes. This is a tool I talked earlier to switch to the to this namespace. And next I will create a label for my master node server. We are going to say that this server has the label run equal monitoring. We'll use this to make the application only run on the master node, which is the only node that has a mount mapped to my computer. Now I will need a manifest to create a persistent volume and a persistent volume claim. This is going to be a space assigned for Prometheus data. We create this with a kubectl apply. We create the two resources. Let's pause a second and examine the persistent volume for Prometheus. It's called Prometheus PV and it has 5 GB. And it's mapped to the Prometheus data in the root folder of the server, which we mapped to my home in the host machine. And also I tie this persistent volume to the master server. The Prometheus PVC allows Prometheus to claim the storage from the cluster. So here, this is Artifact Hub, and we can find here here we have Prometheus, we have the instructions to install. So we're going to copy these both commands. We can select the version or take this out and install the latest version. Now we'll add the Prometheus repository and update the Helm repo database. Finally, we install Prometheus. This is a long command. Basically, we are saying we are going to install my Prometheus into the namespace monitoring, and we are enabling the persistent volume. We are using local storage and we are passing the persistent volume claim. We are also setting affinity, so the application only runs on the master node. That's it, that's installed. Now we need to we are going to see a lot of containers being created and deployments and services. We're going to wait until everything is running. Okay, everything is running. Bear in mind that the services are exposed, they are not secured yet. So this is not a problem because it it's running on my machine and it's not facing the internet. But if you're running this on a cloud server, be careful with external access. So have that in mind. You may need to set up a firewall. If we go back to the Helm output, we can see the URL for the Prometheus server. We are going to need this while setting up Grafana. So save this. One way to check that Prometheus is running and saving the data is to simply list the Prometheus data directory in my host computer. It should have files by now and up to date with the database continually being updated. Now we are going to do the same with Grafana. We are going to create the persistent volume and the persistent volume claim. Functionally, the persistent volume from Grafana is the same. It only has a different name and a different local mapping. It's mapped to / Grafana dat. And finally, the Grafana PVC allows Grafana to claim the storage from the cluster. Back to Artifact Hub, we're going to search for Grafana, the official package and chart, and we are going to copy this to install. Let's add the charts for Grafana and update the repository. Now we are going to install Grafana, same as Prometheus. This is the command. In this case, we are installing Grafana with this name and in the monitoring namespace. And same as Prometheus, we are enabling persistence with this persistent volume claim, tying the Grafana application to the master node. The output shows us how to get the admin password and the URL for the Grafana server. Let's check the deployment. Okay, so Grafana, if we check the output of Helm install Grafana, we see these commands. This will expose the server into our machine as a local host. So we are going to open a new terminal and run these commands. And we'll need to wait a few seconds. We need to keep this window open while we work with Grafana. Going back to our main console, we're going to run the command and get the password for our admin user. Now we are going to continue with our browser, localhost 3000 login, and we are going to use our password to log in into our Grafana dashboard. Now let's go and add the data source. We are going to select Prometheus and remember the Prometheus server URL. We're going to paste it here and at http://, going to go to the bottom of the page and say save and test. We should get a successful message. We can find pre-made dashboards in the Grafana dashboards library. Let's search for Kubernetes and we are going to see some dashboards. For example, this one uses Prometheus and monitors Kubernetes. We're going to copy the ID to the clipboard. Now we can add some dashboards. Here we can select new and import. And here we can select the ID of one of the pre-existing dashboards. We're going to paste the ID and hit load and select Prometheus as the data source and choose import. And that's it. We have a pre-made dashboard. Here we have memory, CPU, network speed, network usage. If we had applications running, we would see the pods here. So this is a basic dashboard that gives you a good outlook of your cluster. You can always add more metrics here, or you can save your dashboard and make changes. Everything you make will be persisted on your machine. So before calling it a day, let's test the persistency. We can use K9S to see the pods, and maybe we can kill some of these pods, and that will be a good way of testing if the persistency is running. Once they start up again, all the data should still be there. So we got our basic setup ready. We are ready to go. I'm going to leave links in the description to our repository with all the code you need. There are a few things to keep in mind when we talk about running these both services in production or an internet-facing cluster. For example, storage. we are using a local disk in this example. It works in a small machine or when we have a small cluster, but it doesn't scale, especially if we are running on the cloud. So both Prometheus and Grafana have different methods for storing data remotely, like we can use an S3 storage or a database. We would need to modify the persistent volume claims and configure both services differently. Also for security, there's a couple of things to keep in mind. The services are not secured. We are not using TLS or domain names. We're not using network policies or an ingress controller. That would be ideal if we are running an internet-facing cluster. And we can also control how Prometheus and Grafana access the resources on the clusters. We can use a role-based authentication to limit what resources both applications can reach inside the cluster. Let me know if you'd like me to do a second part covering these topics by leaving me a like or leaving me a message. You can also subscribe while you're at it. Thank you for watching and see you on the next one.